The morning. So I decided for this vlog that I'd take you through just a random day in my life during the quarantine. So here we are, time check. It is 8:14 in the morning and I got a message from Queen Umi, which is so dope. But yo, shout out to Umi. Check out the introspection visual and the link in the description. She is the queen, she's the best, and it was just so overall great production. So usually I wake up at 8:30 in the morning, and obviously it's before that, but now I'm in this awkward moment of time where I feel like once I go to sleep, I'll never having to wake up again, so here we are. All right, here's a little pan of what I wake up to in the morning. Sometimes I wish I could have these blinds open already, but that would mean the light would come in and I would wake up even earlier. Last thing before I hop out of bed, I had to buy these earplugs because it gets super loud at night. And to be honest, these help a lot. So shout out to this brand. I don't know what it is.
Okay, so we are out of bed and I usually start my mornings off with music. So, oh, and I play this song. Woo, so relaxing.
So, my hair is wild right now, and that's because I have it tied up throughout most of the day. So now it's like this, but we're just gonna leave it for now before we head out. I'm gonna make some coffee, which I do every morning. I'm on my last serving, so lucky for you all, you can see me make my last cup of coffee for now. And yeah, we'll catch you back in a bit. You ever see someone make coffee in a swimsuit before? Well, there you go. So this is sort of the morning meditation. I make coffee every day, unless I don't have coffee. But as you can see, now I don't have coffee. So tomorrow I'm actually gonna go pick up some coffee beans. Wow, that's a loud truck outside. That's hella rude. As I was saying, this is my everyday meditation. It's great because I love coffee. I love the process of making my coffee. And I have this beautiful view outside to watch. So nonetheless, I'm beyond thankful. Usually Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays, I've been doing an Instagram story meditation. It's Thursday today, but I guess I could do a little meditation with you all. I would say today, my body is feeling relatively at 80%. I would say my mind is near 90%, and let that just be a reminder that none of us wake up 100% on most days, and that's okay, because if we did, we wouldn't be people, we would be robots. Does that make sense? So with that in mind, I'm very excited to pursue the day, because so far, it's not even 9 a.m. yet, and I already have so many things to be thankful for. And with that, I feel like the universe has given me things to appreciate, things to build me up, so why shouldn't I give the same back? And as I'm looking forward to today, I know I got work to do, and I know I have a lot of stuff, but today's meditation is to take it one step at a time. To be very present and intentional, which is what I have on my agenda. I know there's a lot, but there's no point of stressing over everything at the same time. Oh my god, gotta hit the second pour. So, let's make this coffee, because that's the only thing on my mind right now. And then we'll take you to the next part of our day. Peace. Crying again. Y'all ready for this? So we're just gonna take it black because we do that most days, and I'm also out of cream, And I do have sugar, but I'm not gonna put sugar if I don't have cream. Make sense? Cool. Good morning. So, I probably didn't explain this earlier, but I was wearing a swimsuit. Actually, no, I did explain it earlier. I'm going on a swim, so we left, we made our coffee. We are walking to the pool, AKA the bay, and I just did a Google map search right now, and I didn't realize the walk is actually 1 mile, which is great because I prefer to walk anyways to get my steps in the morning, to receive this beautiful sunlight and energy. And I also walk back, so we'll walk back together. And I'm really excited. It's really humbling. There's a lot of old people who walk around during the morning, and I want to be like that when I'm older. I want to have that energy. I want to have that drive. So nonetheless, you know, wearing the mask, being safe, and I'm a little hungry. My hair is literally a mess, but you know, don't have a girlfriend, so why should I care? Anyways, I'll update you halfway through the trip. Okay, so we're halfway there. The hair still has no chill, and we're backlit, but super hungry. I had a Jack in the Box munchie meal yesterday. Chicken tater melt. I asked for 5 ranches. Sister gave me 8. I have so much to be thankful for. Wow, and that's all I can think about right now. So I already air fried some chicken yesterday so I can eat it for lunch today. But tonight we're probably gonna eat out and we'll surprise ourselves, and I'll take you there with me. But we're almost there, y'all. The walk's getting kind of tiring. All right, y'all, we made it. We are here, Aquatic Park. Got some nice boats. Golden Gate Bridge is behind all that fog. And there's Ghirardelli Square. And they took down the Ghirardelli Square sign, which is super random. So to be completely honest, it's actually a lot windier today than it has been in the past 3-4 days. And according to scientific law, that must mean that the water is also cold. So fortunately, I can't take you all in the water with me, nor can I leave my camera out to record my swim because I don't trust the public, and I don't apologize for that. But to give you some insight on my route, I start at a buoy all the way at the end here, and I go all the way to this last buoy over there, and then I swim back all the way over there. And I do that a couple of times until I freeze my balls off. Sun is in my eyes, kinda hard to drive. I've been way too nice, I've been too polite. Time the table's mine, I got 4 wheels in the vibe. If you're down for the ride, yeah. My favorite chemicals are already made. All right, my friends, so we're gonna hop in for usually around 40 minutes. I think we get around 2,000 yards-ish, I don't know. The waves push you back a lot, so when you think you're going somewhere, you're actually going nowhere. And yeah, we'll dry off after and report back. But praying for a great swim, and a safe swim, and the best swim. See you in a bit. So, the water was extremely cold for the last like circuit of my swim. But the swim was good today. I really want to see how warm it is to wear a wetsuit. But besides the fact, I'm happy this is my 4th consecutive swim this week, and we're gonna hop in again tomorrow. The waves really started to pick up though during my 3rd lap, but yeah, I respected my body because it was just like, dude, you better get the hell out of here or else you're gonna get hypothermia. But yeah, I wish I could have taken you all in the water with me, but I don't have a GoPro, so we're just gonna dry off, get warm, and yeah, I can't think right now. I need to dry off. I'll see you all in a bit. Medical, I have a medical in over 24 hours. You're the first, and I got 4 wheels in the vibe. If you're down for the ride, cause you already know. So, we're getting that good mile walk back home. My legs are freezing, and I think I should have brought sweatpants. But this is kind of one of the best parts of the morning, to have this really hot cup of coffee and to enjoy the sun. And the streets aren't too crowded right now because of the pandemic, but you know, that means, actually, I don't know what that means. I'm freaking cold and we're just walking back. So yeah, So here's a fun fact. I swallowed a lot of salt water today and I gagged. So I hope that brought a smile to your face. But we're walking home. We're just gonna get into some work and I'll show you my work setup at the moment. After that, probably gonna go on a run, but we're gonna rest up and get warm real quick. Yeah, all right, we took a light poop. We are back in the crib and we're watching my brother's vlog, link in the description if you want to check it out. Let's go. Yeah, so I'm gonna watch this vlog and we're gonna shower, like I said, get to work. So catch you in a bitty. Yo, so we just took the best shower in the world and I feel relaxed. I will take you through my work setup right now and it's really minimal, super small. And I've decided to work on the floor facing the window. Why? Because if I work on the couch, it like just ruins my posture. And I think sitting on the floor helps me be more conscious of being erect and being upright. I also use this as my back support, low key, when I sit on the floor as well. But I'm gonna give a quick pan of what the setup looks like real quick. Here we go. So I got my book on the floor. Shout out to Apple for the wireless keyboard and mouse. I have this elevated so it's less strain on my wrist. Got my block rocker speaker, laptop here, dual monitor. And yeah, I have a lot of work to get through today. So I do want to share a project I am working on with regards to work before I let you all go for a bit. So if you haven't known, last summer I had the opportunity to work as a project manager, aka PM, for a design thinking and innovation internship for students of color transitioning from high school to higher ed. And it taught me a lot about design thinking and how to put together a prototype or experiment or project in a really tight time frame. So shout out to IDEO and the book sprint for helping me put this together. I skipped a lot of steps when it comes to a design sprint, but essentially I was tasked to come up with a 5-day, 1-week essentially, curriculum for new incoming students to my high school who are part of what I would say the most vulnerable populations and transitioning into a predominantly white institution like the school I work at could be a huge struggle for students of color, especially students of color coming from parochial and public schools. So I'm tasked to create this 1-week curriculum that centers identity, community building, and finding a sense of belonging when getting into a new school like the one I work at. So I took a lot of ideas from Bell Hooks and Emergent Strategy from Adrienne Marie Brown, and I put it here in combination with some design thinking. Essentially, the timeline is starting with our story and really rooting ourselves in understanding where these students are coming from, who they are, what they dream of, and transitioning to day 2, which talks about our schools and making the comparisons between a predominantly white institution / independent school / private school and comparing that to the experiences of being in a public and or parochial school. Day number 3 is focusing our community. So again, focusing on the collective and thinking about when we are in pursuit of a degree from high school, who are we bringing into this journey with us and who are we looking for, like looking to serve in other words. Thursday is about celebrating our gifts. So circulating this whole design into centering themselves as powerful students of color. So why do they deserve to be at an institution like the one they're going to attend? Because a lot of students of color, when navigating the hallways and they don't see students who look like them in their classrooms or even as teachers, they'll ask themselves, you know, subconsciously, like, why am I the only one here? You know what I'm saying? And there's millions of reasons and millions of answers to that. So my hope above all of those reasons is to remind our students that they are powerful and that they deserve to thrive and be seen as leaders in the spaces they occupy. The last day centers our liberation. So I wanted to connect this whole course into like what we're really here for. And my philosophy as an educator is that education is our key to freedom, our collective key. So what is it that liberation feels like and who is it in terms of liberation are we working to uplift? What feeds our purpose to seek liberation, not only within ourselves, but in the context of Black Lives Matter, in the context of supporting our immigrant families, supporting those on the margins, supporting indigenous people, supporting everyone out there. What does liberation look like in the collective mindset? And how can we start small? That's what Adrienne Marie Brown talks about. Everything is a fractal. What happens at the large scale always mimics what happens at the small scale. So this design is rooted in four pillars here: to access funds of knowledge and knowledge production for my students, to center their sense of self throughout this whole class. That this is a non-linear design, so this can be taught in any direction, and the hope is that this is a design not for my students, but is made with my students. So starting on day one, I'm gonna let them know what we're gonna get into, and knowing that like all these activities and everything I have planned has an opportunity to shift because my students know what they need best. And lastly, love is at the core of all of this. I have some quotes from Emergent Strategy that I'm hoping to center every day that connect back to the larger question, which is our purpose here. How might we provide foundational tools to navigate identity, work towards a sense of belonging, and build trust with the collective? I also have some deck cards here from my mentors that focus on how to design with liberation in mind and equity in mind. So, wow, that was a lot. I have like actually a million things to say about this project, but the more I talk, the more I realize I need to get back to work. So I'll probably have another separate video where I just talk about my philosophy of education. And I think knowing that I have a million things to say, probably best I save it for all of that. But yeah, we're gonna grind out real quick, and I'll hit you all back after I'm done with work. And we're probably gonna either go on a run. My homeboy Andrew is gonna swing by. He said he's gonna come by on his bike and drop something off to me, which is super, super exciting. But yeah, we'll catch you later. So I think I've been going at this for like 2 hours, but I love making slide decks. So I just wanted to give you a quick insight of the decks I'm making right now. Also, because I got a little simple aesthetic going on. I just finished day one's curriculum. So yeah, my class is called Our Stories, Our Voices. A little description, some context as to who I am, and basically breaking down what we're gonna go through our first day. And it's clean. I like it. All right, so I realized I should probably let you all know what I was gonna eat. It's almost 2 p.m. right now, so it's a pretty late lunch, I guess. But as I mentioned earlier today, I air fried chicken, so I actually popped it in the air fryer just to warm it up because I was warming up some Trader Joe's nuggets, some broccoli, and a hash brown. There's the other serving when I realized midway that I should vlog this. So we're gonna get our grub in, and we're gonna get more work in, and we're just gonna go with the flow of the day. So catch you in a bit again. Yo, so my boy Andrew is downstairs with a gift or something, I don't know. And I haven't seen Andrew in years, so let's go.
Yo, what's good?
What's good, son? Dude. Hey, sir, what's good?
I'm on your vlog, what's good?
Yo, this is Andrew, my homie. What's up, man?
How you doing?
Yo, thanks for coming by, bruh.
Making the bike delivery.
Yes, dude. Sir.
Dude, so I saw your Phil's post.
Oh my god,
yo. Dude, I gotta get you these beans.
Dude, what beans are these? What beans are these?
So this is from St. Frank. It's like they roast over in the Mission. Mission Street in like 7th.
Yeah.
I live over there, so like, they're like my favorite beans.
Dude.
Have you had them?
I have not.
Dude, you gotta try it.
Yo. All right, my friends. It is, don't have a watch, 4:37 on the dot, and we have worked a lot today. We still have unfinished stuff, but we got a lot of stuff done for sure. So we are about to hop on a 4 mile run, and well, I can't take you with me on this camera, but we'll see if I could take some slight pauses because I don't want to interrupt the Nike running app, but I'll try to update you at some point within every mile and probably give you a little debrief of the finish. I think today we are going to run the pier. Nah, we're gonna take you to one of my usual routes, which is near the Palace of Fine Arts. So we're gonna strap up and I'll see you in another biddy. Okay. Quick peep of the running fit. Here we go. Let's go. Oh, all right, so we're off on a run. Music right now. My world 2.0, Justin Bieber. You already know what's good. I have started incorporating runs into, quote unquote, my new lifestyle since I
moved here to North Beach, and what's helped a lot is the Nike running app and using guided runs, which is dope because you get like your own personal coach who cares about you a lot, and I really, really appreciate it. It makes the runs not seem that long. Anyways, one thing I've learned about running, it's really impacted my overall view on like how I do things, but this taught me the value of a warm-up and that smart running is not about running fast, it's about running strong and putting in a good effort. So I really appreciate the first mile of my runs because, you know, I'm just getting started. Mind right, body right, and my hope is to always negative split my miles. So right now, this should be the easiest, and I should be setting pace for what feels right for my body. Also, I got these AirPod Pros. Really expensive, but definitely, definitely dope. So, all right, I'm gonna tune back into the workout, and I'll catch y'all after the first mile. Here we go. All right, first mile down. I think it was 9:31. I don't know if it pauses my Nike running app when I record, but we're doing pretty well. So we're pulling up Fort Mason really soon. Shout out to Nina. We kicked it there recently. It was my first time. I've been running there a lot, so. All right, let's go back to this. So here we are, Fort Mason. Beautiful. Not a lot of people have masks on. That's good. All right, so. We're hitting my favorite section of the run. It's kind of just flat, it's super long, but there's a view of the Golden Gate Bridge, which is right over here. All right, let's keep going. All right, we just finished mile two, 18:18 apparently, which is a significant drop. I don't know if it's good that I'm pushing. I don't feel like I'm pushing, because I am. Or was too slow at the beginning. Anyways, the goal is to beat 8:18 and not die, so keep going. Here we go. Pulling up, Palace of Fine Arts. We're inside with all the stretchers. I love this loop so much because it's not straight and I feel like I pick up more speed around here. But we're still going back. Hopefully I'm almost at 3 miles. But I feel good. We feel good. Let's go. Just finished mile three. I don't know what the split was, but it felt faster. So, we're finishing up this last mile, and we're feeling good. So let's keep pushing. Okay, so we just finished our 4 mile run. Negative splits, and my average pace was pretty good for myself. And I'll share the splits with you all, but I dropped them in. Oh my gosh. But we're out here, Fort Mason. There is not off the grid. I'm not gonna go there, oh my God, I'm tired. We're gonna go to In-N-Out. A great run. Some thoughts. It felt like an overall good push. I think it's great seeing other runners. Motivates me to work harder. And thing I've learned is that it really trains your mind. Like, so you see someone pass you up, like you just gotta stay locked in your own pace because it's your game, right? And you're in control. So I'm thankful for running. I've been swimming my whole life, and I always hated running, but now I love it. So enough talk. Let's go get some In-N-Out. We gotta walk there, so. Whew. So, my brother asked me why I don't run circles. In other words, do a lap and like finish at my apartment. And it's because I like the walk home. Also because of this view. Look at that beauty. Oh God. All right, we are basically at Fisherman's Wharf. And we're gonna browse some In-N-Out, which is over there. And we'll catch you back at the apartment. Let's go, baby.
So we back home and we have number one from In-N-Out, the go-to always. So I'm just gonna indulge in all of this and I think we're gonna cut the video there today. The only thing left on the agenda, which is what happens every day, is I hop on Fortnite with my brothers, but I need to start editing this video because I have 48 hours until this goes up. So in the meantime, yes, I will enjoy this. Thank you for hanging out with me today. I had a lot of fun and it was cool, you know, living by yourself can be cool, I guess. But yeah, if you were entertained, as always, please hit that like button, drop a comment, anything you want. I'll take anything, honestly. And hit that subscribe button so you can catch me and something else next week, Saturday, 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And I hope you all are doing well. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And until then, peace.
let me say one more thing before you all go. I have hit 400 subscribers, so thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart for everyone who has subscribed to me in the past, has been an OG when I started this channel and put out dance videos, to this new wave where I've been putting out insight vlogs, everyday vlogs, everything. It means a lot. Like, you show that you commit to me, and I try my best to commit to this work, to commit to myself, and to commit to providing content for all of you. So thank you for the 400. I hope for another 400, and you can help me by just clicking subscribe. That's it. Let's eat some In-N-Out. Love you again. Peace. Yeah. Want some loving, want some loving.